Kaiser here with weekly solo number 12, which is actually going to be three different kinds of solo things from three different times in history. The first will be now, and then we'll take a couple of different trips into the past. All use this guitar, my Steve Klein electric guitar with a Steinberger tremolo, Alembic pickups, and a really great, crazy German celluloid pickguard on it. I love this guitar. It's the guitar that's probably traveled the most with me. It's been to Norway with Lindley and I. It's been to Madagascar with Lindley and I. In fact, you can see it on solo number 8 of these cuneiform solos where I'm playing with Lindley and the Rossi Band in Madagascar in 1991. And it's just a special guitar for me. It's probably the guitar that's on the most records, and I use it still to this day. Knock on wood. Last October, I was in the studio with some friends of mine on guitar besides me, my friend Chris Muir, the person I played music with the longest, Stefan Thalen from the Sonar Group from Switzerland, my pal Lucas Ligeti, who I've played with forever since I met him when he was a teenager. And when I went to see his father, Georgi Ligeti, received the Graumeier Prize in, was that in Louisville, Kentucky? I think it was. And Conlon Nancaro introduced me to Lucas, and Lucas said, I play drums. And he was a teenager. Then I said, well, let's make a record. And we've made many, many records since. And Andy West, very special bass player, who was amazing in the Dixie Dregs, was amazing in Crazy Backwards Alphabet and The Mistakes, two bands with me in the past. Andy and I have worked together for a very long time, and it's a total pleasure to work together. So we were all in the studio in October, and we made this album, some composed things, some improvised things, kind of a fusion record in the vein of Five Times Surprise, in a way. And Andy had a really interesting tune in 11 that was really difficult to play, so he and Lucas on drums, Andy playing the six-string bass, cut the basic track without the rest of us. And this week, I've been working on overdubbing my solo, or a couple of solos on that. And I was setting up to do that, and I thought, well, let's make this week's video solo for cuneiform instead, and I will play over that track. So here's kind of a muddy mix of the backing track. Sorry, Andy. Muddy mix for me. And I'll just play over this little solo space three times with this guitar and not really think about anything. It's kind of like automatic writing. It's just, I'll just go nuts. So here we go. A track of Andy West in 11. Thank you. now let's get the time machine out and let's go back to 20 years ago when I made this DVD, a bunch of guitar solos, and on it I played different guitars, Teufel Tesla there on the front, on the back, me in 2001 at South Pole Station, Antarctica, my job in Antarctica using the South Pole for a guitar slide. Amazing. I got away with that. Anyway, here's me introducing that guitar 20 years ago. And then 30 years ago, here's me and the Henry Kaiser Band playing at the Palms in Davis, California, playing Jimi Hendrix's tune, Are You Experienced? So it's John Haynes on drums, Kerry Sheldon on vocals, the great Bruce Anderson and I on guitar, Hillary Haynes on bass, and Grateful Dead alumni, the amazing keyboardist Tom Constantin. And this was a jam band before there were jam bands. And I think we were the first people really to be covering Dark Star and things like that before all these other people do now. But so here is just a little excerpt from Are You Experienced, where this guitar gets to say what it wants to say. And I'll put in my old intro from the old days, so you'll see me with this guitar 20 years ago, and then you'll see me 30 years ago playing Are You Experienced. Let's go. My white Klein guitar. I love this guitar. I went through my archives, and I found an old videotape from 1990 of the Henry Kaiser Band performing Jimi Hendrix's Are You Experienced? And it has, I think, my favorite guitar solo I've ever seen of myself on video in the middle of it. I like this. And this is the Henry Kaiser Band, Bruce Anderson on guitar, John Haynes on drums, Hillary Haynes on bass, Tom Constantin on keyboards, Kerry Sheldon on vocals. Back in 1990, this guitar, previous lifetime, Are You Experienced?
Thank you.
One of my favorite collaborators over my many years of playing has been a painter in Japan, Kazu Yanagi, who's an action painter. He does very large paintings as performance events, and often the paintings are preserved or become part of the buildings. And we played together many times in the U.S. and in Japan. And I happen to have this old video of us playing in a bank in San Francisco, I think, where we played for 5 or 6 hours, neither of us stopping, no bathroom breaks. And he made this incredible painting, and I made a big air sculpture of guitar that was more ephemeral than his painting that would be gone now, except I've got this little video from a TV news show of it. So I hope you enjoy this guitar today, my Klein. It's called a Klein Custom Electric. That's just the name of the particular model. It was a revolutionary guitar at the time. And so this is probably, I'm not sure what year this is, but I think it's either 90 or 89. It could be 88, right when I first got it. So here's the old me taking you back 30 years ago or so to the young me with this guitar. Thanks for joining me today. Bye.
In order to express myself through live painting, I needed some big space and big wall. So I look around and I found one in downtown San Francisco. And I showed the whole process in the front of the people. Empty my brain in the front of the canvas and concentrate. And as much I can just free from all kind of attachment. Just I made myself very free. Then start purify the whole wall with some water. I think water is kind of important to our life. So that water is a kind of big element to me. Same time, probably music will come. Henry Kaiser will play the guitar. His music and my painting is just go together, and sometimes not go together. But many moments, it's really fit each other. The music comes in my ear, and the music helped me to push and go again to the wall. The whole process called live painting. Live painting instead of live music. Show the whole process in the front of the people. In the studio, you can use time as long as you want. But sometimes if you limit yourself with time, other type of imagination will come out. People don't have to stay like many hours. Half an hour here, and 1 hour later again, half an hour, and hour later again, half an hour. So they see the progress of my painting. So that can be interesting too.
And it's always interesting to watch the creation of something. Being a singer and performer myself, it's rare that we allow an audience in the development part of some artistic work. But I enjoy it. And the colors, I especially like when you started doing the black lines. It's really exciting.
Once I start doing something on the canvas, or painting the canvas will have a character. Canvas start having a life. In the beginning it was blank, but when I put my kind of thought on canvas, canvas start speaking. And canvas start talking to me. I'm a one creature, and the canvas become a one creature. We start, you know, play around. We communicate each other. So that's the whole process called live painting.